Hello everyone, welcome speaker. This is the second part of the book, The Man from the Egg. So in this video, I will cover the last part of this book, which is called as Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. So in this video, we will cover all the stories of Lord Vishnu. So the first story is The Bones of Dadhichi. This is the story of Dadhichi, who was a kind sage and an ardent devotee of Lord Vishnu. He used to be the guardian of the Devas' weapons. One day, when Devas did not wear their arm for long, Bhoot Dadhichi used a special mantra called Madhu Vidya and transformed the weapon into the liquid and drank the solution. Mighty Asura named Mitrasura had obtained a boon that no weapon of metal or wood could kill him. So he became arrogant. When people reached to Indra for help, the god immediately went to sage Dadhichi to reclaim the divine power. Aware of the Asura's boon, sage Dadhichi told Indra, hence he drank the dissolved weapon water. The Lord can use his bones to create weapons which are neither wood nor metal. Thus their victory is certain. Story of the journey of the ocean. When Indra was cursed by sage Durvasa that all Devas will soon lose their strength and become a weak reflection of their own sleeves. When Devas approached Lord Vishnu, he advised them to churn the ocean, as there is a bottle of nectar at the bottom of the ocean which will make them drink. So the ocean churning began between Devas and Asuras. Mount Mandara was invoked as a route to balance Mount Mandara. Lord Vishnu took the form of turtle to balance the mount. The churning released many things. The first was Goddess Lakshmi. The second was Kastuba, a valuable jewel. The third was fragrant divine flowering tree called Parija. The fourth was Moon God, who was followed by deadly poison. Lord Shiva drank the deadly poison, which got trapped in God's neck. Then came the Ashwini Kumaras. Next was Kamdhenu, the divine cow. Then the white elephant with five trunks, Airavata, followed by seven-headed horse, Uchashrivana, and then the Apsaras. Lastly emerged the nectar. Vishnu took the form of Mohini and cheated Asuras and delivered the nectar to the Devas. The 10 Avataras. This is a story when Lord Vishnu promised Mother Earth that he will be born and reborn again when Mother Earth is in trouble. So the first avatara was Matsya Avatara, in which the god was born as a fish and protect Mother Earth from the great flood. The second was Kurma Avatara, when Lord took the form of turtle and played his role during the churning of the ocean. The third was wild boar Varaha to slay the great Asura Hiranyakasha. The fourth avatara was the half lion and half man Narasimha to kill Hiranyakashipu. The fifth avatara was the Vamana, in which he defeated the mighty Bali. The sixth one was the Parshurama, who punished all the mighty rulers for their mistakes. The seventh avatara was the Rama, when he killed the king Ravana. The eighth avatara was Lord Krishna, when he killed Kansa and Shishupal. The ninth avatara was the Buddha, when he taught the importance of spiritualism. The tenth avatara is yet to come, when God will appear on the white horse on Kalki and destroy the evil in the world. Three moral lifetimes. This is a story of two demigods named Jaya and Vijaya, who were Vishnu's guard at Vaikuntha. One day, when four Kumaras came to visit Lord Vishnu, this guard stopped them and didn't allow them to enter. Frustrated Kumaras cursed that the two guards will be born on earth as mortals and live far away from Lord Vishnu. When they both realized their mistake and begged the Kumaras to forgive them, so the Kumaras gave a choice that they can either be born as friends of the Lord and complete seven lives on earth, or can be born as an enemies and for three lifetimes and die at his hand. They both accepted the second choice. They first born as Hiranyakasha and Hiranyakashipu and were killed by Varaha and Narasimha Avatara of Lord Vishnu. Second, they were born as Ravana and Kumbhakarna and were killed by Ram Avatara of Lord Vishnu. And last, they were born as Shishupal and Dantavakra and were killed by Krishna Avatara of Lord Vishnu. After completing three lives, they went back to Vaikuntha as God's guard. The next story is A Friend in Need. This is a story of Bhasmasura, who got a boon from Lord Brahma that a person will turn into ashes when he will touch the person's head with his palm. When Bhasmasura become arrogant, people pleased to Lord Brahma for help. Lord Brahma went to Vishnu for help. Lord Vishnu took the form of beautiful maiden Mohini and went to Bhasmasura. Enchanted by her beauty, Bhasmasura expressed the wish to marry her, but she replied that she will marry an extraordinary dancer. Bhasmasura requested Mohini to teach her dance. They practiced for a long time and Bhasmasura repeated all the steps after her. Finally, she put her hand on her head, so does the Asura, and reduced to ashes immediately. Mohini was transformed to Lord Vishnu. The Elephant and the Crocodile. This is a story of a king named Indrayamana, who was a devotee of Vishnu, who was cursed by sage Agastya that he will be born as an elephant and will search desperately for water. When king requested sage to take back the curse, the sage said that he will return to his true form when the Lord comes for him. In the other part of the world, Gandharva was cursed by sage Vivala that he will into a crocodile in his next world. One day Gajendra, who was Indrayana, was taking a bath in a river. He was caught hold by a monstrous crocodile. When all his effort got vain to come out from the hold, he called out Lord Vishnu. Finally, Lord Vishnu appeared and killed the crocodile. Thus, both the creatures came back to their original form. Next story is The Man from the Egg. This is a story of King Kashyap and his wife. He had two wives named Vinuta and Kadru. Kadru had 1,000 sons and Vinuta had 2 sons. One day they had a bet, and by cheating, Kadru ended up winning the bet. Hence, Vinuta became her slave. Kadru and Vinuta both lay eggs. Kadru's egg hatched first, however, Vinuta's egg does not hatch. Frustrated, she broke one of her eggs, and to surprise, she found a boar inside the egg with undeveloped legs. Later, he became charioteer of the sun god. She was careful with the second egg, so one day the egg broke and mighty Garuda emerged from it. The forged tongues. Since it was the duty of Garuda to rescue his mother from the slavery of Kadru, he went to Lord Vishnu to get the precious nectar which Kadru demanded in return of his mother's release. So Garuda went to Vishnu for asking the pot of nectar, but Lord Vishnu refused. Finally, after a fight between Lord Vishnu and Garuda, God agreed and offered him the pot. Garuda handed the pot to Kadru and rescued his mother. According to Lord Vishnu's plan, Indra went to Kadru and told her that her children should take bath before drinking the precious nectar. Kadru immediately agreed with Lord Indra. Seizing the opportunity, Indra grabbed the pot of nectar, but unfortunately, few drops of nectar fell on the hay that was lying outside Kadru's house. Few snakes who managed to come back early saw the drops on hay and started to lick off the drops. Since the hay was sharp and dry, the edges cut their tongue and was splitting them to two. The Honest Traitor. This is the story of Jalandhara, who was born from Lord Vishnu's arrow, which hit the ocean. He marries to Brinda, who was a great devotee of Lord Vishnu. Jalandhara was a fine young man, and he was crowned as a ruler of Asuras. Few Asuras made him aware of the fact how God cheated them during ocean journey. They swore him to take revenge against the god. Though Brinda advised her not to wage a war against the god, but he did not heed her words. So she could pray frequently to Vishnu for his safety. Soon Jalandhara became furious. One day he decided to fight against Lord Shiva. Since Brinda was the reason of his safety, there was no other choice than to deceive her. So Vishnu disguised himself as Jalandhara and went to Brinda and told her that he won the war and he did not need to pray to Vishnu anymore. Seizing his opportunity, Shiva killed Jalandhara. When Brinda realized the truth, she cursed Vishnu that he will turn into stones. Vishnu accepted the curse and turned into Shaligram near river Gandaki. And he also told Brinda that she will turn into Tulsi plant and her leaf will be used in the worship, in his worship, and people will revere and keep Tulsi plant at their homes. The next story is A Choice of Death. This is a story of two Asura brothers called Madhu and Kaitava. They prayed to Goddess Lakshmi in the hope of attaining immortality, but she denied, giving them one more choice to ask as a boon. So they chose to die at the time of their choice, which Parvati agreed. Soon they become ill and one day asked Vishnu to have a fight with them. Vishnu agreed and according to Parvati's script, she entered the Asura's mind and made them give Vishnu a boon. So they asked Vishnu what they want. The god asked the boon that they both should be killed by his hand, and finally they were killed by Lord Vishnu's hand. The last story is to marry a monkey or a bear. This is a story of Princess Srimati, whose father King Ambarish was looking for a good match for her. One day when Narada and a young sage named Parvata went to visit Ambarish, they both fell in love with the princess. They both expressed their wish to marry the princess. So King decided to have an official Swayamvara and let the princess choose the groom of her choice. In desperation, Parvata went to Lord Vishnu and asked him to change Narada's face into face of monkey. When the princess will look at him. Similarly, Narada went to Lord Vishnu and told him to change the face of Parvata into that of a bear. So God agreed to both the wishes. The same thing happened in the Swayamvara. The princess could only see the bear and the monkey, and she also saw a young handsome man and she wished to marry him. The man was none other than Lord Vishnu, because Srimati was an avatara of Goddess Lakshmi and she can only be with him. The last story is the Web of Illusion. This is a story of Narada, who was once told by Lord Vishnu to grab some water for him from the ocean. Narada agreed and went to the ocean. Suddenly he saw stunning white steps below the surface of water. Following the steps, he saw a beautiful maiden. Narada falling for her and asked her to marry him. Soon they married and he became father of 6 children. One day, a terrible storm came out of nowhere and he lost his family. When the storm hit him, he started to pray to Lord Vishnu. Soon he felt someone tapping on his shoulder. When he opened his eyes, he saw Vishnu by his side. Then Lord Vishnu explained to him that he created the Maya, that is the illusion, so that he could understand what a common man life is. So this ends the summary of the book. I hope you liked the video. If you like, then you can give it a like, and I will leave the link of the first video, that is the first part of this book, in the I button and also in the description box. You can go and check it out. So see you all in the next video. Till then, keep reading.